shoes you ride down. At all your feet. Take you home with me. Put you in my house. Boom, 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 boom. Mm-hmm. I love to see you walk up and down the floor. When you're talking
all right.
To me.
Welcome to this episode of The Angry Beekeeper. It is May 27th, the weather's perfect, and I'll tell you, sometimes I get a good feeling. On the way here, we stopped at another bee yard. I caught two swarms. It was really exciting. My cameraman was here. Maybe we'll be able to interject some footage. It was just a lot of fun. It's always fun catching swarms. But I thought I would talk this week about setting up a bee yard. I've caught so many swarms this spring, I literally had to start another bee yard that I'm just filling with the swarms that I caught, okay? Now, when you set up a bee yard, you gotta be forward thinking. How many hives do I want here? What do I wanna do here, okay? Now, what I like to do is get in and cut the grass. And I'll tell you, this grass was waist high and it put my Chinese lawnmower to the test. But it cut it fine, we did all right. So then you go and you want to look for level spots, okay? Now, typically on a farm, you end up with a little corner somewhere that's not really workable, and I have a little piece here that they really couldn't get the tractor in, so it'll suit me just fine. So next you want to do, after you cut the grass and you've looked for some level spots to put your skids, you want to level the skids. And I don't know if you can see, I've got little wedges of wood here and there, because you want your hives to sit as level as possible, and if anything, maybe tilting to the front just a little bit so the water doesn't run in the bottom board. Now, these skids were free, okay? And with the price of lumber going through the roof, it's getting harder and harder to find skids. The other day I ordered a clubhouse sandwich and it was 30 bucks, and apparently what ran the price up was the three toothpicks they stuck in that sandwich, okay? That's how dear lumber is getting, all right? So now I've got these skids, and I actually put additional pieces of wood on the top of the skids, so just to prolong the life of the skid so that the hives don't end up falling through the skid, okay? Now also, I've painfully learned, maybe one day I'll have a riding lawnmower. So I wanna set things up such that if I hit this with a riding lawnmower, I can get between the skids and efficiently mow it, okay? And I'll tell you one thing about bee yards. I've been in a lot of bee yards with a lot of different beekeepers. And right off the bat, when I approach that bee yard and there is broken bottom boards and lids and junk scattered everywhere, to me that says you're doing the minimum. You're not really out to look after your bees. It says you're lazy, it says you're sloppy, and maybe you're not taking this serious, okay? Also too, if all us beekeepers keep our bee yards an absolute mess, the landowners aren't going to be as quick to give us that little piece of space, okay? So don't make a mess and create an air of professionalism in the bee yard, okay? If you were to search the planet and find the opposite of a graveyard, this would be it. The bee yard is just so full of life. This is an amazing place to be. I love being here. It always gives me a great feeling. Every day in the bee yard is a great day, okay? When God made the world and he gave it a big spin, he made trees, he made flowers, and he put bees on there to gather the nectar of the gods, okay? And we are so fortunate that we get to work with bees and we get to enjoy their honey, okay? And you can see with the price of lumber, I've had my daughter and Mrs. Angry paint the boxes and they've chose some pretty wild colors, and that's fine. As long as it's not black or red, I really don't care, okay? Why not red or black? Because the black holds the heat too much, and apparently bees can't see red. So that's always been my rule. And with the price of lumber, I want these boxes to last as long as possible. That's why we're painting them now. In the past, I never painted brew boxes because I felt that maybe condensation might occur on the inside. I don't know, we'll see what happens. But like I said, the price of lumber is getting crazy, okay? Our motto: I take care of the bees take care of me. Like, share, and subscribe, or it'll make me angry. Thank you. not a hound dog, crying on a train. Bee yard that I'm just filling with the swarms that I caught, okay? Now when you